BYU-Idaho students Indy and Josh Davis had a fairy tale ending to their wedding, but it didn't always look like it would end up that way.
My parents, of course, told me since I was young that I was going to have an arranged marriage, and I had no say in it.
Indy was born a Buddhist. She joined the church 3 years ago. She is the first convert from an ancient Sri Lankan family.
I was Buddhist. That was my first religion, and my parents grew up as Buddhists. Our whole ancestry, extended family, everybody is Buddhist.
Indy has known her entire life that she would have an arranged marriage.
And my parents were like, when you go to Sri Lanka, you're going to meet some guys, and then you're going to, you know, see if you like one, and then you can build up a relationship for a couple of years and then end up getting married.
Meeting Josh Davis changed all of that.
So I told my parents that I was dating Josh, and then at first they were like, no, you're not. You don't approve of this. This is not going to happen. No. And they're really not happy about it.
After Indy and Josh met and fell in love, they decided to go visit her parents to see if they might change their minds. Indy describes her mother's reaction.
You know, I had my mind set on it that I was not going to like him. I was going to say no, and then you're going to have to marry a Sri Lankan. But then she met Josh, and then she was like, you know, Josh, you just can't not like Josh.
The excited couple were married first in the Seattle temple in a sacred Mormon ceremony.
But then they did end up coming out to Seattle, and then we did have a temple wedding, and they were fine. I mean, they didn't say anything about not going inside. I think there was a lot of people to, you know, talk with them, so they don't realize that they're not inside watching the wedding.
Then both families traveled to Sri Lanka for a traditional Buddhist wedding, complete with an entourage of singers, dancers, elephants, and of course, the traditional wedding attire.
So there were layers and layers of cloth, and his butt looked huge. It was just, it looked like an elephant butt. So, and he was wearing a jacket that had the arms that comes out, like, to represent the ears.
The couple could not have had a fairy tale wedding without the love and openness of both of their parents.
My parents were really excited about it. They were very supportive of it. I have an aunt who's full-blooded Korean, and so we're kind of used to that cultural diversity in the family, and they were really excited, mainly because they had met Indy, and they absolutely fell in love with her. She's such a sweet girl, and so they were really excited to kind of bring that cultural element into our family and experience that as well.
For Indy and Josh Davis, what could have been a clash of traditions ended up being a happy marriage of families and cultures. This is Michelle Backlund reporting at BYU-Idaho, Scroll Digital.